Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings that you care for them. You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You have made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Welcome, good morning to Arlington Life Live at our new time of 9:45. My name is Heidi Jackson. I will be your host. And this is my twin sister, Kathy Cruz.
Hello.
And as you can see, you know, Kathy and I, we're always getting teased about, are you guys twins?
Yes.
And we don't understand why anybody would think that, because we are obviously not twins.
No.
And so we thought we would just sit next to each other to show you and illustrate that we are not twins. And if we were, I came 6 years before.
That's right. I am the smarter sister, though.
I think I feel like the wiser sister, huh? Anyway, I'm sorry, we are getting so off track already. Unlike before, we're not going to be having a second segment of Arlington Life Live, because we are going into our PC times for worship, our pre-COVID times. And so we're going back to the schedule we had before COVID. So we just want to kind of share what that schedule will be.
That schedule is going to be Legacy is at 9 a.m.
Yes.
And Arlington Live is at 9:45. YG is at 10:15, as well as YG Life is at 11:15. And our third service, Mosaic, is at 11:30 a.m. We also have outdoor worship at 10 a.m.
And don't forget, your Sabbath schools are also at 10:15. And so, you know, that's for in-person Sabbath schools, and are we still having virtual?
We still have virtual.
Okay.
It's going well. We still have a lot of kids attending.
Okay.
I am teaching pre-K and kindergarten, and I have I see 5 to 7
kids every time?
Every time.
Okay.
So
you're teaching pre-K kindergarten. So this is special right here, because I don't think I could do it. But she's been doing it for all of 2020, basically.
Yeah.
You know what? It might be good. A lot of people don't know that you're actually a teacher.
Yeah.
You've got a degree in elementary education.
I have a BS degree.
All right.
In early education,
so
yes.
So tell me a little bit of you know, why you chose to be a virtual Sabbath school teacher for pre-K and kindergarten.
I really feel like it was a God thing, because at that time, I had just got a new job that wasn't teaching. And I was like, oh, no, am I not going to be a teacher anymore?
Yeah.
And then that door opened.
Yeah.
And I love it. I've been teaching since COVID shut down.
Yeah.
And just kind of like, everybody at that time was kind of with the unknown and not sure what's going on and a little bit scared. And so it was really nice to, you know, show the kids that God is, you know,
God is
faithful,
here.
He's here.
We're all together.
We're all together in this. And so it's been a really good ride.
Okay. And so what I need to tell you is that I, you know, Jordan was at the end of kindergarten when virtual started. And so he was attending kindergarten. Then Jordan's my 7-year-old right now, son. He's 7-year-old right now. But when COVID started, he was younger. And he started attending your virtual Sabbath school class, which actually became a blessing to me, because he would come and he would say, Mommy, the big idea today is God loves us no matter what, or, you know, trust in God. And so it would just always be, and I would just listen to you in the background, and I would be amazed This is the best sister of all time. And my son, he is now in first grade, about to go into second, and he still loves his auntie's virtual Sabbath school. So
yeah, I love when
we
he
may
comes
need
in.
To move him up for second grade, though. I'm going to have to tell him that you might have to let go and go into the next one. But definitely it's been a blessing for me personally. So thank you.
Thank you, yeah. Sister.
Oh, thank you. Before it gets too cheesy here, we have VBS is coming up June 21 through 25. We invite you to go to, you can register on Arlington Life online, or you can go to arlingtonadventist.com and register there as well. The spots are limited, so you'll want to register. It's going to be a great time.
It's going to be awesome.
Allison has been planning, Pastor Allison's been planning it.
Yes.
And it's going to be awesome. It's going to be outdoors. Your kids are going to have fun, and so you're going to want to register immediately and make sure that your child has a spot this summer. Did I say it was from June 21 through 25? So yes. Mark your calendars accordingly.
Yes. And yeah. Let's talk about what happened this last week. Food pantry.
Yeah. Oh man, so
tell us more
okay,
about it.
So we don't have our meteorologist here, Reggie Herman, but had he been here last week, he would have told us probably to cancel our food pantry because there was a 70% chance of rain. And so, and it always, you know, anytime it rains, there's always like a high percentage and everybody's saying, you know, you're probably going to need to cancel or this or that. But we have been doing something and it's so overwhelming. It has never rained for Food Pantry. This Wednesday was a 70% chance of rain. There was a storm cell coming.
The winds, the skies were dark blue.
And the Tarrant Area Food Bank said, you know, do you want to cancel? And we trudged on. We just kind of, it's really a faith builder. We just prayed and we asked the Lord to please hold back the rain. Yeah. And I personally asked him, if you could hold back the rain until after Food Pantry and Vision Clinic, because they were both on the same day. And you know, not a raindrop fell from the sky. And so not one raindrop fell from the sky, because the Lord is so good. He cares for his people. And he cares that they get fed. And so 201 families came by. Imagine if we would have canceled. They would have been without their food.
Tell them about what Jesse had said. It had been raining all day.
I came home later on and my husband said, so did it rain? And I said, no. And he's like, well, how could that be? It rained all day here. We live just about 20 minutes away. And so God is good. He cares for his people. He loves us. And he cares about the little things. And he is the chief meteorologist. So he cares about us. And so I'm so thankful that he...
What's amazing is that we had Vision Clinic in the evening.
Yes, we
from
did.
From 5 to 8.
Tell us about that.
It still didn't rain. Yes. We saw 22 patients, mm-hmm. and it's really awesome to see, you know, these patients come mm-hmm. and then leave with a smile on their face because they're going to be able to see. So we saw 22 patients, and we have another Vision Clinic coming up on August the 25th. So
yes.
Once it comes around, we'll
give you
talk.
More information. Yeah. Definitely. You know, it's like she said, it's just so awesome to see people that they have not been able to see. A lot of them have, mm-hmm. You know, have told me that this is the first time in 5 years that they've really been able to, you know, to see. And it's because they wouldn't have been able to without this ministry. So your dollars, when you donate, your dollars go to programs like that. That's how we're able to do that. We've partnered with Better Vision, Better Hope, and they send out doctors to come, and they cover a portion. The church covers a portion with your support, and we're able to allow people that are not insured, because it's really hard to be insured. It costs a lot of money.
Yes.
It's very difficult. And so it allows people that aren't insured to be able to come get an exam and come get glasses. This time we charge $25. Sometimes we charge $10. It all depends on pricing and stuff. But it was definitely a blessing to our community. I'll say one more thing. We had a special patient that she decided she was going to pick Vision Clinic because she said, well, she wanted to come to Food Pantry, but she decided she was going to pick Vision Clinic because she decided she was going to pick her vision before her hunger, or before, you know, getting groceries. And so, of course, we worked it out with her, and we gave her both. But that is a reality for a lot of people today, you know, that just can't afford insurance, mm-hmm. something so simple. So in the future, you're going to see Revive going in the direction of, you know, trying to take care of those people that, you know, are good people, people like you and me. There's nothing wrong. It's just simply that life is hard, and sometimes you need a helping hand. And that is really what Revive is all about. And I think that the members here at the Arlington Adventist Church are committed to loving people no matter what. And I feel that, and I'm proud of us for doing that. I feel like the Lord is looking down on us and smiling when we give to those in need. Real quick, look to May for Revive. It's going to look a little bit the same. I was hoping that we'd be open in May, but what we're going to do is we're going to take our time moving back in. Construction should be done in May. We're going to take our time moving back in. We're going to take our time getting our Revive restored, clothing back where it needs to go, our food where it needs to go. So we will be opening in June. Revive Restored will be opening in June, and our pantry will also be opening in June, God willing.
Yes.
And so everything will be the same. There will be no Tuesday donation Tuesdays or anything like that. However,
I did notice this week at Food Pantry that a lot of them were asking for if we had diapers, and we didn't have diapers.
No, we didn't have diapers this time. This is the first time we didn't have any diapers.
Oh, man. So we need diapers.
Yes.
Lots of them.
Yes.
Sizes 4 through 6.
Yeah. So if you're listening, diapers is, and you have the time and you have the resources to buy even a box of diapers, a bag of diapers.
Yes.
They really appreciate that.
They really
that is
do.
One thing. You know, if you think about it, a box of diapers can be like $25. So you can save $25 and actually buy food or buy something that you need. It means everything.
Everything. We also need, we're starting back again to collecting rice and beans,
yes.
correct?
Yes.
So bring rice and beans as well.
Yeah.
And
because you can put them... we're not going to have Donation Tuesday yet, like we usually do, but you can just bring them to the foyer. You can bring them to the office during business hours. But we're going to start with rice and beans because in June, we know we're going to need it.
Yeah.
And so we're just going to start stocking up on rice and beans. Diapers is are a must. And that way we'll prepare ourselves for that.
Yes. So tell us a little bit about homeless ministries.
Okay, I'm glad you told me that because glad you reminded me. Homeless ministries is starting up. It actually had started. It started right before COVID hit. A week before, we went and served at the Samaritan's House, which is a shelter. a shelter for people that are homeless or are about to be homeless. It's a shelter for them, a wonderful shelter. And so we did a little pilot group, and we served dinner for some of the residents. It was a really great experience.
It was a blessing for us. 2-3 weeks before COVID?
Yes.
Or was it?
Yeah, I think it was a week before everything shut down. And so we haven't been able to do that. Instead, we've been making food. I know Yuji has gone, and we've been making food primarily. But I just want to look ahead at homeless ministries. In June and July, we're going to start doing more. June, we will start making sack lunches. We're going to start passing them out where it's needed. There's more information on our website. If you go to revivecommunitycare.com and just click on homeless ministries, or you can go to arlingtonadventist.com, mm-hmm. And you can also do the same. You'll find us in both locations. But there's some good information there, and that is where you can sign up if you want to volunteer for that. There's also another opportunity. Well, before I say that, in June, it'll be every first Sabbath of every other month, starting with the even numbers. So it'll be February, April, like that. All of our dates are on our calendar, but that's just a quick way to remember where we will do sack lunches. But we're also going to be making and serving food for the homeless as well. We're going to be doing that once a quarter, I believe. And so, you know, that that's a great opportunity for Sabbath schools, small groups, small groups, even a couple of families that want to come together. The teams are going to be about 8 to 10 people. And so all of our dates are already online. There, you can sign up there.
Have you seen people signing up?
Yes, I've seen a couple of people sign up.
Okay.
But I just want to put the word out there. I know it's not anywhere close to June or July right now, but it's coming, and we just want to be prepared. We want to have our teams in place.
Yes.
And we just ultimately want to be the hands and feet of Jesus in our community.
Do we need anything for anything that we need to bring?
You just sign up, and then Angie Henderson is actually, she's the leader of our homeless ministries, and so she will contact you. She'll let you know if you need to bring anything. Tell you details. So you'll get email reminders. You'll know exactly what you need to do. You just have to sign up first so that we know you're coming. And all the information is online. And if I can say one more thing.
Yes.
Homeless Ministries is also collecting some things, right?
Yes.
We're collecting...
Bibles.
Spanish Bibles.
Yes.
Spanish Bibles. We're collecting...
Board games and foam balls.
And
foam balls,
yeah,
yes.
There we go. See, the two of us combined, we will remember. So we're collecting those things. For the migrant children that are being housed at the K. Bailey Hutchinson Center, I believe that sometimes God uses unusual situations for a bigger purpose, a bigger blessing.
Amen.
It's That's an unusual right. situation. It isn't within our state, and these children are children, and they need to play. And they need to hear about Jesus.
They do.
And this is a unique opportunity for us as a church to bring a Spanish Bible that they might not have had access to where they were. And so who knows? Even if one person comes to Jesus because of something like this, so worth it.
It's so worth it.
Yeah. Yes. And so it gives me kind of chills to just know that God's hand moves in all of our circumstances, unusual or not. And so we've just got to take advantage of every opportunity that we're given to serve his kingdom and to love one another.
That's right.
And so that's what we're going to do. And we're going to be collecting for the month of May. These items, you can bring them to the foyer or you can bring them to the office during business hours. And yeah, so those are the announcements for today. I want to leave a word of encouragement to you this morning. No matter what you're going through, God sees you and he loves you. This is the Sabbath day, a day that the Lord has made for us to rest and enjoy him and one another. And so we're going to be doing that. I hope that you have a wonderful Sabbath, a wonderful day. Take opportunity to go and do something with Jesus today.
Yes.
Even if it's just you and him, that's okay. So we're going to go ahead and sign off here, but it's been wonderful to host with you.
It's super awesome to be with you.
Yes, my twin, and also to share this time with you. So we will wish you a happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
And stay tuned for, I believe, YG is next.
Yes.
Here we go again, my mind racing. dancing, and I can't seem to win all these crazy thoughts and feelings. It's like it never ends until your voice breaks in my noise. I know I'm not alone, not alone. You'll find my battles if I will just be still. Why would I keep running when you're here? I'll just be quiet and let you speak through the silence. Here I am, no more hiding. You are in this moment, I won't fight it. I'll be quiet. I don't need to know what comes next. Tomorrow's in your hands. I can trust you with my future, 'cause you're in this moment, I won't fight it. I'll be quiet.